我们是比较少的，把孩子带好，培养让他把我们的女儿变成工人，培养让他给我们去上学。
Yes, yes.
He was in trouble with the law and left it out of the country. But these two big cats, no one knew what happened to them. Whether he turned them loose, who knows? But the timing was almost spot on. It was too much of a coincidence for it to be anything other.
A decade after the Exmoor saga in the neighbouring county of Cornwall, another unusual pattern of livestock kills and sightings was occurring during this period. Paul Tyler was the elected regional MP.
I was elected MP for the Bodmin area, actually it was called North Cornwall by this time in 1992, and by that stage there had been quite a lot of reports of livestock kills in and around Bodmin Moor, which is quite a wild area of the country. And right back to the late 80s, there have been worries about these kills. They didn't seem to be by dogs or foxes, which would have been much easier to explain away. It did seem to be,
thanks
to everybody else that was involved in this, particularly the farmer, that there was something bigger and more dangerous there. Potentially, of course, to lambs and calves, but also potentially a mother with cubs defending her family to children. And that risk to human beings was one that caused a local policeman to come to meet me again, and the NFU locally to say, come on, we're going to do more of this. So I brought them together at a meeting in Bodmin in the summer of 1994, and we made representations to the Ministry of Agriculture that this needed to be properly examined. We made these representations, I in Parliament, but the NFU, of course, to the Ministry as well. And eventually, the Minister agreed to set up a desk study. They did not go out onto Bodmin Moor. They didn't get anybody out of Rangers or the Army or anybody else to track down what was going on. All they did was interview a smaller number of livestock farmers, look at some of the
photographs that had
already been provided by local people. The eventual report, it took 12 months, over 12 months, I think, to get a report out. What it really said was, we can't prove it isn't there. It's a sort of double negative, which was very unsatisfactory for us. But in the meantime, I and others were concerned very much more about public reactions, actually, than whether the government, the ministers, were really on the ball on this. The important point was, we did make people more watchful, more careful, because what we didn't want there to be, of course, to be an attack upon human beings, and for people also to be much more aware of the potential damage to young livestock.
Simon Chapman is a retired police sergeant. During the 1990s, he was in charge of the police call centre for Devon and Cornwall Constabulary.
In November 1993, I was a sergeant in the Devon and Cornwall Police. I was a control room supervisor, and that's when we took a call from a guy who said he'd released what he described as a big cat on the outskirts of Torquay. He wouldn't say where he'd left the cat, he just described it and said why he did it.
I have a large cat in my pocket here, large cat, that's the peculiar, there, and there's a little pocket here, there, and he's getting through the pocket. I'm not saying that was there, but I believe it. I had it for a while, and basically I couldn't control it because I couldn't feel the pain at all.
A day later, a lady was driving between Torquay and Newton Abbott, and she went into the police station to report that she had seen what she described as a big black cat, which kind of gives some credence to the report that we'd taken previously from the other gentleman.
Benjamin Mee is the owner of Dartmoor Zoo in Devon.
So in 2006, my family bought Dartmoor Wildlife.
It's a normal plane to be in the sky in the storm.
The first week of arriving, you know what I mean? Seeing the big cat in the building. Apparently, Ellis Dorr, the previous owner, let out three pumas. Or maybe he didn't accept them when they were transferred over from the zoo that was closing in Plymouth. There are different versions of it. But the bottom line is that under his watch, three pumas. A male and two females were released on the farm, and I've now spoken to many neighbours within a sort of mile or 2-3 mile radius of here. And they all agreed that there were big cats, which would sometimes take livestock and then also return to the zoo to answer the mating call of the female pumas that were kept here.
We are now absolutely in an innovations race.
They've changed our world forever. Each a story of ingenuity, wonder, and revolution.
And it's this setup that's been at the heart of almost every car built in the last century.
Ideas that change the world starts Christmas Eve from 3 on Blaze.
Hey Sainsbury's, can we do a big Christmas spread without a big bill?
Of course. This week get your turkey, roasties, veg, gravy and stuffing.
Don't forget pigs in blankets.
And a trifle.
A £4 a head, that's a great price.
Sainsbury's, good food for all of us.
And the new Absolute Platine Yves Saint Laurent.
Usually I will go and get myself a nice cup of coffee, get my fluffy socks, sit on my sofa, all cuddled up in the corner, legs up, arms comfy, and I start to play. It's my time, it's my me time. While everybody else is doing their things in the house, that's my time for me to enjoy to play. And it's fun. So yes, I love you.
Do as Lisa. Search for Happy Tiger Bingo. Happy Tiger Bingo. Low stakes. Roaring Bingo Fun.
Now stay safe, darling.
Yes, the taxi's here. Holiday call.
What's that?
That's our very sure alarm. 24/7 in the morning. Relax on holiday without it.
Oh, you'll have to.
Sort one out for you when I'm back on.
Very sure alarm.
I'll put it
free security camera and solar panel installed with your zero vision alarm installation. Call now or visit.